यूपी सीएम श्री योगी आदित्यनाथ जी, मिनिस्टर पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस श्री धर्मेंद्र प्रधान जी, मिनिस्टर्स ऑफ एनर्जी फ्रॉम गेस्ट कंट्रीज, कैप्टन्स ऑफ द ऑयल एंड गैस सेक्टर, एक्सलेंसीज, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड डेलीगेट्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, नमस्ते। एट द आउटसेट आई अपोलाइज फॉर द डीले लॉजिस्टिक रीजन्स। आई एम डिलाइटेड टू वेलकम यू ऑल टू पेट्रोटेक 2019, द 13th एडिशन ऑफ इंडियाज फ्लैगशिप Hydrocarbon Conference. I would also like to congratulate His Excellency Dr. Sultan Al Jaber for his contribution to the energy sector and vision for the future. Over the last quarter century, Petrotek has served as a platform to discuss solutions to challenges that we face in the energy sector. In each of our respective countries, we seek to deliver affordable, efficient, clean and assured energy supply to our citizens. The presence of over 60 countries and 7,000 delegates is a reflection of that common quest. Several decades of public life have convinced me that energy is a key driver of socio-economic growth. Suitably priced, stable and sustainable energy supply is essential for rapid growth of the economy. It also helps the poor and deprived section of society to partake of economic benefits. At the macro level, the energy sector is a pivot and key enabler of growth. Friends, as we gather here to discuss the present and future global energy, winds of change are evident in the global energy arena. Energy supply, energy sources, and energy consumption patterns are changing. Perhaps this could be a historic transition. There is a shift in energy consumption from west to east. The United States has become the world's largest oil and gas producer after the shale revolution. Solar energy and other renewable sources of energy have become more competitive. They are emerging as sustainable substitutes for traditional energy forms. Natural gas is fast becoming one of the largest fuels in the global energy mix. There are signs of convergence between cheaper renewable energy, technology, and digital applications. This may increase the speed of the achievements of many sustainable development goals. Nations are coming together to tackle climate change. This is visible in global partnerships such as the International Solar Alliance promoted by India and France. We are entering an era of greater energy availability. But more than a billion people across the globe still do not have access to electricity. Many more do not have access to clean cooking fuel. India has taken a lead in addressing these issues of energy access. In our success, I see hope for the world that problems of energy availability can be suitably addressed. People must have universal access to clean, affordable, sustainable and equitable supply of energy. India's contribution in the onset of an era based on energy justice is significant. Currently, India is the fastest growing large economy in the world. Leading agencies such as IMF and World Bank project the same trend to continue in the coming years. In an uncertain global economic environment, India has shown tremendous resilience as an anchor of the world economy. India recently became the sixth largest economy in the world. According to a recent report by 2030, India could be the second largest world economy. We are also the third largest energy consumer in the world, with demand growing at more than 5% annually. India remains an attractive market for energy companies, with energy demand expected to more than double by 2040. We have adopted an integrated approach towards energy planning. During the last PetroTech conference in December 2016, I mentioned four pillars for India's energy future. These are energy access, energy efficiency, energy sustainability, and energy security. Friends, energy justice is also a key objective for me and a top priority for India. Towards this end, we have developed and implemented many policies. The result of these efforts are now evident. Electricity has reached all our rural areas. This year, we aim to achieve 100% electrification of households in India through a targeted program called Saubhagya. As we raise production, we also aim to reduce losses. Our Uday scheme working toward this objective. India's World Bank ease of getting electricity ranking improved from 111 in 2014 to 29 in 2018. LED bulbs distributed across the country under the Ujala scheme have been of 17,000 crore rupees or nearly 2.5. Access to clean cooking fuel provides major benefits, especially children at risk of exposure to smoke pollution. LPG connections have been given to over 64 million or 6.4 crore households in just under 3 years under the Ujwala scheme. A blue flame revolution is underway. LPG coverage has reached more than 90% from 55% 5 years ago. Clean transportation is getting a boost. We are jumping directly from BS4 to BS6 fuel by April 2020. This is the equivalent of Euro 6 standards. Achievements such as 100% electrification and increased LPG coverage are possible only through people's involvement. Energy justice can be done only when people believe in their collective power. Government is only an enabler in converting the reality. The last 5 years have seen major reforms in India's oil and gas sector. Our upstream policies and regulations, we have launched carbon exploration and licensing policy to bring transparency and competitiveness in the sector. The binding criteria had been changed to revenue. This has helped reduce government intervention. An open acreage licensing policy and a national data repository is helping in increased exploration interest in Indian fields. Gas pricing reforms have also been introduced. The enhanced oil recovery policy aims to promote the use of latest technology in improving productivity of upstream fields. Our downstream sector has been completely liberalized. Market-driven petrol and diesel prices reflect changes in the international price of crude oil. India has the fourth largest refining capacity in the world. This will further grow by about 200 million metric tons by 2030. A national biofuel policy was enacted last year. Research on second and third generation biofuel is being promoted. 12 second generation bio refineries are being set up in 11 states. The ethanol blending and biodiesel program is reducing carbon emissions and raising farmers' incomes. Bioaviation turbine fuel has already been tried out in our civil aviation sector. Our government has encouraged private participation across the entire oil and gas value chain. India is becoming an attractive FDI destination. Companies like Saudi Aramco, ADNOC, Total, ExxonMobil, BP and Shell are looking to increase their investment across the value chain. India is making rapid strides towards the gas-based economy. Our 16,000 kilometers of gas pipeline has been constructed and an additional 11,000 kilometers is under construction. Execution of 3,200 kilometers of gas pipeline in eastern India has begun. This will connect Northeast India with the national gas grid. The 10th bid round for city gas distribution will be complete in a month's time. This will cover over 400 districts. It will extend coverage of city gas distribution to 70% of our population. we are gearing up for Industry 4.0. This will change the way industry operates with new technology and processes. Our companies are adopting latest technologies to improve efficiency, increase safety, and reduce costs. This is being done in downstream retail as well as in upstream oil and gas production, asset maintenance, and remote monitoring. In recent years, we have deepened our international engagement with organizations such as the International Energy Agency, and we chaired the International Energy Fund from 2018 to 2018. Able to convert traditional buyer-seller engagements into strategic partnership through bilateral investments. We have also promoted our neighborhood first policy by strengthening energy engagement with Nepal, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, and Myanmar. I have regularly engaged with global oil and gas sector. In my interactions with world leaders and CEOs, I have always maintained that gas are not only a commodity of trade, but also of necessity. Whether it is for the kitchen of a common man or for an aircraft, energy is essential. For too long, the world has seen crude prices on a roller coaster. We need to move to responsible price which balances the interest of both the producer and consumer. We also need to move towards transparent and flexible markets for both oil and gas. Only then can we serve the energy needs of humanity and in optimal manner. Another key issue that needs the world to come together is climate change. Together, we can achieve the targets we set for ourselves at COP21 in Paris. India has made rapid strides in meeting its commitment. We are on our way to reaching the targets. PetroTrack provides the perfect setting to ponder over the future of the energy sector. It is a good platform to reflect on how global shifts, transitions, policies, and new technologies will influence market stability and future investment in the sector. I wish you all a successful and fruitful conference. Thank you. Thank you very much.